Bistability is the ability of a system to actually exhibit two stable states. For example, this puppet toy, it's able to be in this particular state, but then if I press, I'm able to get it into a second stable configuration. That means that it has two stable configurations. That's why it's called bistability. Depending on how many DOMs do I invert, it will get into a specific position or a specific curvature. And this allows us to put it in different systems, such as grippers or walkers or other type of robots. The metastable one is quite interesting because if, for example, this dome is metastable, so when I press it and I hold it for a couple of seconds, it will stay there for a little bit and then it will go back after a certain amount of time. So what this allows us to do is to kind of program a time-dependent response in our systems, just informed by the geometry of our units themselves. So one of the main results we actually show is that we can perform classification tasks. So basically the robot goes, tries to grab an object. If it's not able to grab it, then it will go to the next level of aperture and they will try again and so on and so forth until it detects a small contact. And the second system that we have is this walker. We now have one direction that goes into kind of to the right and then another direction that allows us to move the legs like this, right? So that creates a walking motion. All of that is programmed in the robot's legs itself. It's not on an external system, it's already programmed in the legs to the ability to turn and to go forward and backwards. And of course, with an enhanced performance due to that metastability. The main goal to achieve this autonomy in robots by using physical means, it's towards using this system in more difficult or rough environments. Let's say electronics are extremely good in some aspects, but they don't shine in extreme environments like, for example, in space or nuclear reactors. Exploration in oceans and marine life, it's quite difficult. When you rely a little bit more on the physical systems, then those systems will still work on these hard environments. And I will dream to see one of my researchers actually achieve this.